How can a complete climate test laboratory for high-voltage batteries fit into a 40-foot container? Here we will take a look at the climate chamber for environmental simulation, the media conditioning of the battery pack, the charging and discharging stations, the cooling circuit and the indoor climate in the container, the automation system and the performance of typical high-voltage battery tests, including the safety controller. The time needed for each test sequence is determined by both the equipment of the walk-in climate chamber and the size of the battery pack. Battery tests are usually carried out at temperatures between minus 40 and plus 80 degrees Celsius. The humidity can be regulated to a value between 10 and 95%. The Plug and Test Lab's test chamber can accommodate a battery pack up to 2.6 meters long and 1.8 meters wide. If the test chamber were empty, the temperature gradient would be 6 Kelvin per minute. If, for example, the test chamber contains an 800 kg battery pack and a 200 kg test rack, the temperature gradient would only be 3 Kelvin per minute. In this test scenario, it would therefore take less than 20 minutes to heat up from a room temperature of 22 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. The refrigeration compressors are compactly mounted on a frame in the container. The battery pack is connected to the media conditioning system just like inside a vehicle. Up to 120 liters of water glycol mixture is pumped into the battery pack at a maximum of 6 bar per minute to dynamically control the temperature of the test specimen. A flow control system with a magnetic inductive measuring method and adjustable pressure limiter is installed to protect the test specimen. The media conditioning can cool the test specimen down to minus 40 degrees centigrade or heat it with approximately 16 kilowatt. The heart of the mobile climate test laboratory are the compactly built charging and discharging stations. An efficiency of 94% is achieved thanks to the implemented silicon carbon semiconductor technology. Each charging and discharging station offers an output of 250 kilowatt. Up to 500 kilowatt of electrical power is available when up to two of these units are connected in parallel. A peak power of 600 kilowatt can also be achieved for 30 seconds. 1000 volts of output voltage and 1000 ampere of current are used for a wide range of battery tests. The control of the charging and final charging stations is highly precise with a measurement accuracy of 0.03% and allows current jumps in 0.4 milliseconds. The test for special battery types and functions, such as the ripple function, are already pre-programmed. The refrigeration units of the climate chamber, the media conditioning and the charging and discharging stations are connected to a cooling circuit. The excess heat is dissipated via the cooling units on the roof of the plug and test lab. In summer or winter, a self-contained split air conditioning unit maintains a pleasant room temperature inside the container. Air purge systems ensure sufficient ventilation both in the climate chamber and in the machine room. All components of the mobile climate test laboratory are connected via the central automation system. This includes the real-time controller, the host and application computers, the interface to the battery management system, the control system of the test chamber, and the slot for the digital and analog inputs and outputs. All of the components exchange information in real-time via the bus system and can be integrated into the test sequences. The junction box with digital and analog inputs and outputs is located in the test chamber, close to the battery pack. This is where measurement signals such as voltage, current, temperature and pressure are recorded and transmitted in real time. Conversely, high voltage interlock loops, ignition and crash signals, and signals for the control of auxiliary systems are output via the junction box. The high voltage contact between the charging and discharging stations and the battery pack is established via a separate sub-distribution. Typical high voltage battery tests include carrying out charging and discharging cycles, the simulation of driving and load profiles, insulation and leak test for quality inspection, and simulation of varying climatic conditions and entire seasons. The safety of people, test specimens, and measuring equipment during battery tests is extremely important. Therefore, the safety-critical parameters of the battery pack are redundantly monitored by the automation system as well as by a safety PLC. All signals for sensors and actuators of the safety chain come together in the safety PLC. This includes a gas sensor system that detects and indicates the presence of fire, and a high-pressure water mist system that pumps water into the chamber at approximately 100 bar via atomizing nozzles. The resulting very fine mist evaporates almost immediately and, despite a relatively small amount of water, provides a large amount of effective cooling to contain fire damage. Furthermore, the safety PLC monitors sensors for locking the doors, warning lights, horns, and emergency stop switches. Pressure may rise in the climate chamber in the event of battery damage. For safety reasons, the climate chamber was designed to withstand pressure and relief valves were installed in the roof. All safety measures are designed in accordance with the WISE technology standard at hazard level 6.